Hi, today we will have a look at the insides of this device. So yes, it is one more Russian avionics test device. It is my bigger one, I think. This thing is huge, 40 centimeters wide, 31 of height, and almost 25 of deep. So it is a test device for some aircraft system, it seems. It is written here Proverka Korektorov Bolly something. Model is IBP. Your serial number here on this thing. So we have three main multi-pin connectors. We have a power supply 115 4400 hertz and 27 volts DC. This is the main power switch, as far as I can tell. This must be power good lights fuse. Then we are going to a main stuff. Function buttons, some lights here. You have a broken lens here, but it is a standard thing, so maybe I will be able to find another one someday. Here, some dial instrument, as an aircraft instrument, you can see, with the light system. Usually they are mounted on the top of the aircraft, but here they are on the bottom with little light shooting things. Potentiometer here, one more fuse. Here, main function switches. And this, on the right side, seem to be some resistor decade. On the top, just a big handle, nothing special. On the back, nothing. I am missing the special cover for it, with maybe some cables inside. I did not receive it. It was not available with the item. You can see there are some reinforcement pieces here on the side to make it stiffer. And last calibration. Next calibration was for 1993. Okay, now I will remove all the screws around and we will have a good look inside. So first, look how shiny is the inside of this box. Really, really nice. This is a reinforcement plate for the handle on the top. The fit with nice bolts on the bottom. And guys, here are the guts. So I don't think I will take everything apart, but we'll have a good look. So first an overview maybe. So there is on this panel all the buttons, wirings and so on. Two main circuit boards here. One the instrument. Aircraft-like instrument. maybe I will be able to pop the backside out of it, at least. One electronic module here and one other PCB here. So first about the wiring work in this thing. As you can see, it is pretty well made. Very, very tidy. Big multi-gang rotary switch is here. Be serious, the switches are nice aircraft grade quality. Maybe you can see better on this side here. So everything is very, very nicely made. So this instrument can be removed because there is a plug here, obviously. And here I have one small round, excuse me for camera movement, but it's not easy to deal with such a big thing. Some round circuit board. It looks like it may be an aircraft instrument design for the circuit board design for going into an aircraft instrument. Some more switches here, transformers. And the middle here, more green paint transformers. And this nice module, which seems to be also a module made for using into avionics. They did put in this. Really, really nice quality. So we'll have a look on the PCBs. I guess the most interesting thing is this precision resistors here. Probably for the decade resistor switch on the backside here. So there are lots of precision wire wound resistors. This one are bigger even. On this small module here, you can see small signal transformers. And at the back, so if you see this white bug things, are dead bug round transistors or maybe ICs, op amps, or something like this. Okay. And on this side, mainly, it seems power supply stuff, big capacitors, diode bridges, lots of them, by the way. And this must be some inverter relay. Look, we have a climatic on it. Yes, oscillating relay to make high frequency pulse for power supply. It is quite obsolete now. Model number is VPG6. 62, written here. Date code of 1986. So here also we have a pretty interesting design of like this, maybe you can see, of heatsink on these transistors. They are mounted on the rear of the transistors. Okay, now I will try to undo this back cover on the instrument and see if we are able to find out what is inside without doing any damage to it. Must be just 4 screws to remove. I hope so. I don't remember if I did already open it previously. And yes, it is coming out, so it is nice. I'll just to undo the connector here. excuse me, I have some stuff making noise. Okay, now I can remove it and we can have a good look to it. Obviously, here it is. As you can see, spare no expense here. Very nicely made thing. Main motor here. Synchro motor, synchro resolver, something like this. Taper motor, maybe even. Not sure. Some mechanical stuff here with two digit counters on the main dial. And this must be feedback potentiometers. Big multi-turn feedback potentiometers. And I guess the resistive wire is a spiral thing all on all the length of the thing here. Apart from that, some more precision resistors, one capacitor here, and it is all, but you can see how nicely made it is. Not the best high precision thing, but really, really strong. And here you can see the inside of the body of this instrument. Really thick, one piece of thick aluminium. Really, really good thing. Okay, what else? I think it is almost everything for this, in fact. You can see the nice overall quality of everything. Conformal coating everywhere. And the interesting part are these two modules, which seems to be borrowed from Avionics. This one and this one here. You can see there is a rubber seal on the all around the cover. And the most the wiring work on this thing one more time is absolutely amazing, as you can see here, for instance, back there. Really, it must be hours of man work to make such things. And for not helping, all the wires have the same color. It must be a nightmare to do with wire looms. It is tidy and beautiful when it is installed, but imagine when you need to connect all the wires on this big connector, and they are all the same color. I do not know exactly how they proceed. There is not even a wire number written here. Sometimes on this it rings, they write, they stamp some number, but not here. So it is just incredible, this thing, in fact. I got it from German eBay a lot of years ago. And it was, if I remember correctly, it was almost free. I did pay more shipping than the item price. It was maybe 10 euros or something like this. But you do not find such deals anymore now. It becomes really, really hard to get. You have to search a lot of time in all the categories to find the item which is miscategorized and with a poor description. And then sometimes you can find a good deal. But problem with German sellers, not everybody wants to sell abroad, and not everyone take PayPal. So it is sometimes really annoying. Okay, so I will reassemble this thing and it will go back in storage for another bunch of years. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.